Sometimes us Pentecostals get a little bit spoiled, because when we get in a moment of prayer, we're encouraged. Pray in the Holy Ghost. Pray in the Spirit. And that's wonderful. We should pray in the Spirit. But a lot of us relegate our prayer lives to praying in the Spirit and letting the Holy Spirit do for us what God has instructed us to do. Hallelujah for the Holy Ghost who helps you pray. The Word of God says that He comes alongside to help. And when we don't know what to pray for as we ought, the Holy Spirit will begin to pray through us with groanings which can't be uttered. And we pray in tongues, and He completes that prayer and makes it a perfect prayer. But listen, that doesn't negate the fact that God intended for you to learn how to articulate with your words what it is you're asking Him to do. He wants you to think about it. He wants you to articulate it. He wants you to put together a sentence and string together some words and begin to speak those words and begin to articulate what it is that's deep on the inside of you that you are believing Him to do. And many would say, well, why is that so important? Here's why. Because when you find the strength to articulate what it is you're asking God to do, you are giving Him permission and invitation to come and move in that situation on your behalf. Praise God. The Holy Ghost is the paraclete. He's the one called alongside to help. He's not called alongside to replace. Hello? So if you relegate your prayer life to 2 hours between 10 and 12 on a Sunday morning, or between 2 hours of 7 and 9 on a Wednesday night, and then when you're praying, you make sure that it's mostly in tongues, you are robbing yourself of a wonderful opportunity that God has given you to use the same creative, prophetic power that is wrapped up in a word that He used when He created the worlds.